do you know what it takes?
The both of them just reminds me.
At that level.
All right, guys. Man, I got something on Davido actually trending on social media. A lot of people are now talking about it. You know, even a particular social media influencer called Adeshope Olajide, or who normally speak, has a show of, you know, has a show, you know, where he speak about some, you know, influential artists and, you know, celebrities around the world. And he did say something about Davido, and that I'll be showing you the video so that you will get to understand that, man, this Davido, forget about, you know, Grammy Award, forget about this thing and other things. Yes, he's still an influence in Africa. With 20 million followers, Davido having one of the, you know, highest, being one of the highest stream on YouTube and the rest, that is also an influence, and we need to celebrate our own. And he still says something about whiskey and the rest, but I think whiskey, to an extent, we still need to respect whiskey. You know, it's not easy to attain that kind of height in musical career, you know, at that young age. I have a video right now making around on social media. You know, Davido explains why he and Wizkid can never agree together, and that is already trending on social media. Before I jump fully right in to talk about this on social media in this video right now, I want you guys to kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification icon to always get notifications each time I upload my videos. But if already subscribed, thank you for subscribing, and make sure you share my videos across social media platforms so that others will get to see what is trending and what we are talking about on social media. Yes, a particular, you know, kind of an influential guy, you know, on entertainment, have spoken on social media right now. You know, the video that made him viral on social media, on YouTube, you know, even on Instagram and other social media platforms, he said something about Davido, that Davido, apart from P-Square, Davido is one of the artists that was able to conquer, you know, kind of East Africa, down to South Africa, down to, you know, kind of West Africa, the rest, and we should give him kudos for that. It's not easy for one man to actually do, you know, and we still understand that Burna Boy is influential to an extent, because having a Grammy Award is one thing that most artists around the world, they actually dream of having. And Burna Boy was able to get that Grammy Award, and Wizkid also got a Grammy Award. You know, it was you know, a collab Grammy Award for Wizkid, and some people are saying that Burna Boy's Grammy Award is better. But right now, this person came out to say, man, Davido is one of the greatest. It's not easy to conquer musically, you know, East Africa, down to South Africa, down to West Africa, down to Middle Africa. That is actually huge right now, because Davido is on people's lips. And no wonder he was able to, you know, amass 20 million followers on Instagram. That is actually huge right now, has increased the earnings of Davido. What do you have to say about that? Put that in the comment section as I let you out on the video.
And let me shock you and remind you that none of them fell out of that level till today. Do you know what it takes?
The both of them just reminds me.
At that level for 10 years, and people say you don't have talent, yet you can do a 2-hour show with hit records back to back. David was the first entertainer, bar P-Square, that picked up his bags from Kenya to Ivory Coast, Ivory Coast to Tanzania, Tanzania to South Africa, South Africa to Ghana. Concerts, collaborations, features, performances, promoting himself beyond his market.
That's crazy.
He was the first after P-Square. Nobody else.
Yeah,
I think done that. So when we celebrate Wiz for his greatness, and Burna and Yemi and Tiwa and whatever, we have to clear
the road for
David. David sits.
No, sure, of course. Yeah.
Do you know how many rich kids are in the game now? Do you I don't want to mention them to you. You'll be shocked. Do you know how many rich kids are in the game now? But they still can never sniff. They can't sniff David's ankle. If it was the money, there are so many rich kids in Afrobeats right now. Some of them have even fell out.
But that's my point.
Some of them are gone with their money. They carry the money come.
Guys, to an extent, I think this guy is actually making a real sense. But some people will come out and say, man, he must be a Davido fan. He must be like this, me like that. But sometimes these guys, they speak the real truth. And, you know, it's not easy to talk, you know, fact, truth as a blogger, because without getting some kind of backlash from a lot of people, that is something you need to understand by this whole thing that is trending right now on social media. But anyway, you know, kind of Burna Boy is one of the biggest that, you know, has a song, his African Giant, was able to stay on chart, on world chart, for 36 weeks. And that is actually huge. Davido and Wizkid made it 25-25. And that is also a huge testimony for, you know, most musical artists in Nigeria right now. We need to actually celebrate our own and give them kudos to an extent. That is something I keep saying in my videos.
Okay.
Yeah. Yo, it's crazy. I'm in Atlanta.
Yes, a recent video made it on social media. That was 9 years ago. Davido actually said and explained why him and Wizkid can never agree together, because we have a lot of bad artists, we have fans problems, we have a lot of issues in Nigeria entertainment industry, and this spoke about something, and I think it's worth interesting to actually listen to right now.
Like when I first came, everybody was on this, you trying to be like Wizkid, there's any Wizkid, just different stuff, and I was like, okay. Now Wizkid is huge. Everybody knows that. You know what I'm saying? He has his own swag. He's young, he's fresh. You know what I'm saying? So I can't go with that same swag and say I want to do my stuff. I have to do something different. So at least we can be, even if he's going like this, me, I could be going like this, up my own way. So that was really what I wanted. Because in Nigeria they love bad people. You know what I'm saying? They love bad, as in good artists, crazy. And I wake up every day telling myself, there's somebody out there that's better than me. There's somebody out there that's better than me. But they don't have like this opportunity, so I can't even slip up. If you relax now and then, like I look at myself like them, Moe's, they have over 80 hits. 80, I have 3. So, you know what I'm saying? This is just beginning. I'm just trying to really, really know my every after one move, I'm looking for the next thing to do. Like now, I have my next 2 singles already.
Wow.
We're shooting the video, featuring Wandeko. So, you know what I'm saying, we're ready. Oh, yeah, man. The funny thing is, you mentioned Wizkid. Obviously, Wizkid came over here almost, I think, a year to the day now. Around a year to the day, for the first time in the UK, we had the opportunity to speak to him, thanks to the EME boys. Yeah. And it was almost like, you know, an introduction to the younger Nigerians with so much talent. Nobody expected Davido to kick the door open as well. You're still a young man as well. You're extremely young too. 19. Damn, I called Wizkid, you know, the Justin Bieber.
Yeah,
I don't know what to refer to you as now, because if Wizkid is doing Justin Bieber, you are completely kicking it as well. You're making sure that this generation has got so much talent. Tell me about where music started for you.
I was about 13. I was in high school. I formed this little group with my friends. So we used to rap, you know, just joke around and stuff. I used to go to this studio in Ikota, somewhere in Lagos. So I used to be there just watching. I just asked the guy, yo, come and help me install this stuff on my computer at home. So since that day, the guy just installed it in my computer. I'll go to YouTube or just talk myself everything. You know, at first I wasn't singing, I was just a producer, only producing for MPZ that time. So this is my cousin.
Yeah.
So after we did that, it just didn't work out. We shot 2 videos. I was like, man, I don't think this is for me. I don't understand. Wiz was big, everything. So I was like, damn, what do I do? But let me not be greedy. People inside the industry helped me a lot. Wiz, one day, to Don Jazzy especially. You know what I'm saying? I didn't just come. I went to see everybody. I was like, okay, look, this is what I'm planning to do. They told me their own ideas. Okay, this is how I should do it and stuff. You know what I'm saying? There's a lot of hate in the industry, but I mean, there are those few that, you know what I'm saying, showed a lot of love. So after that, I was in America. I moved to America just for a year for university. And then one Christmas, I came home like this. I was like, I'm not going back. And my dad was like, are you nuts? You better go back to school, blah, 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 blah. So I was like, I decided to stay. Yes, man. So me and my dad were just arguing, fighting. Yeah, so I flew out to London, came here a year ago. This Elephant and Castle Road, that's where I recorded back when. I saw it, Old Kent Road.
Yeah,
that's where I recorded back when. A year ago. I came here, like when I say yeah, from the day I recorded back when, that's when I was like, okay, I'm going to do my solo career.
Guys, what can you deduce from this? I need that in the comment section below so that we can talk about it further. Before I jump right off, I want you guys to kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel, hit the subscribe button below and the bell notification icon to always get notifications each time I upload my videos. But if already subscribed, thank you for subscribing, and make sure you share my videos across social media platforms so that others will get to see what is trending and what we are talking about on social media. And don't forget to drop your comment in the comment section below so that we can talk about it also further and expand the whole thing. But you guys need to actually keep supporting FreeWellsDeep, share my videos across media platforms, because this is now our channel now.